हेलो स्टूडेंट, माय सेल्फ दिगंत सखेवाला, आई एम योर साइंस टीचर। वी विल कंटिन्यू अवर चैप्टर, चैप्टर नंबर 10, लाइट रिफ्लेक्शन एंड रिफ्रैक्शन। टुडेज टॉपिक इज इमेज फॉर्मेशन बाय द कॉन्केव लेंस एंड कॉन्वेक्स लेंस। सो वी विल टेक हियर वन कॉन्वेक्स लेंस एंड वी पुट द ऑब्जेक्ट एट इनफाइनाइट डिस्टेंस। सो व्हेन वी पुट द ऑब्जेक्ट एट इनफाइनाइट डिस्टेंस, व्हेन ऑल द रेज पास फ्रॉम द कॉन्वेक्स लेंस बाय रिफ्रैक्शन, दे मीट एट वन पॉइंट। सो वी गेट द इमेज एट प्रिंसिपल फोकस and the size of the image is diminishes and it is real and inverted on other side of the lens. Second case, in that we put the object beyond the 2f1, so two rays are passed, one ray is parallel to principal axis and other ray pass from the optical center. The first ray pass from f2 and second ray pass from the optical center, they both are convergent rays, so they meet between f2 and 2f2. So we get real and inverted image. We get the real and inverted image, and the size of the image is smaller than object, and we get the image on the other side of the lens. Third condition, in that when we put the object at 2f1, two rays are passed, one ray is passed parallel to principal axis. After refraction, it passes from the f2. Second ray passes from the optical center. It goes directly, and it meet on 2f2. Okay, we get real and inverted image, and size of the image is same as the object, and we get the image on the other side of the lens. Next condition, in that we put the object AB between the f1 and 2f1. Two rays are passed, one ray is parallel to principal axis. After refraction, the ray pass from the f2, second ray pass from the optical center. We get the image beyond 2f2. We get real and inverted image, and size of the image is magnified, and we get the image on other side of the lens. Next condition, in that we put the object AB on the f1, two rays are passed, one ray is going parallel to principal axis and it pass from the f2, second ray is going pass from the optical center. We get the image at the infinite distance. We get the real and inverted image, and the image is obtained on the other side of the lens. This is most important when we put the object between the f1 and optical center. Two rays are passed, one ray is going parallel to principal axis, so after refraction it goes in the other direction of the lens, and another ray pass from the optical center of the lens, and it will go in the other side of the lens. We get the image by extending the line on the same side of the lens, so we get here virtual and erect image, and size of the image is magnified. Here in the concave lens, when we put the object at infinite distance, when the ray of light pass from the concave lens, all the rays are going in different direction because they are divergent rays. So by extending, we get the image on the same side on principal focus. The nature of the image is virtual and erect, and it is diminishes on the same side of the lens. When we put the object between optical center and infinite distance, two rays are passed, one ray is going parallel to principal axis, it goes in different direction after refraction because it is a divergent ray. One another ray pass from the optical center of concave lens, and it will also go in different direction. By extending, we get the image on the same side of the lens. So image is obtained between the F1 and O, it is virtual and erect, and it is a diminishes. So this is all about the image formation by the concave lens and the convex lens. We will learn a lens formula. Lens formula is 1 upon V minus 1 upon U equals to 1 upon F. Okay, that we will learn. So for that, we consider here convex lens. We put the object beyond 2F, okay, and we get the image. Now from the object AB, two rays are passed, one ray pass parallel to principal axis, so it intersect here at D point. After refraction, it pass from the F2. Second ray pass from the optical center of O of the lens, and the both the rays are meet between F2 and 2F2. Okay, the rays are meet between the F2 and 2F2. Here we get a real and inverted image. Okay, and size of the image is the smaller than the object. Okay. What here the distance between the optical center and object are there, that is called u. U is negative according to Cartesian sign system. Here ऑब्जेक्ट डिस्टेंस बिटवीन द ओ ऑप्टिकल सेंटर एंड बी डैश दैट इज द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन द ऑप्टिकल सेंटर एंड द इमेज इज वी वी इज पॉजिटिव बिकॉज अकॉर्डिंग टू कार्टेशियन साइंस सिस्टम. ओके हियर वी हैव टू फोकल लेंथ आर देयर एफ वन एंड एफ टू. If we consider OF1, then that is negative. If we consider OF2, then that is positive. But we will consider the OF, that is the positive focal length. Okay, OF2 we will consider. Okay, all the thing is given. Object distance equals to OB equals to minus U. Image distance equals to OB dash, that is V. Height of the object equals to AB equals to H. Height of the image equals to A dash, B dash equals to AH dash. Now, dear student, we learn about the similar triangle. Similar triangles are those triangles in which their sides are in proportion and their angles are congruent. That is called similar triangle. So, we will use that. Here, we have two triangles. Are there triangle ABO similar to triangle A dash B dash O? ABO and triangle A dash B dash O, they are similar triangle because their sides are in proportion and their angles are congruent. So, we can write proportionality. We can write that AB upon A dash B dash, AB upon A dash B dash equals to OB upon OB dash. So we can write here AB upon A dash B dash equals to OB upon OB dash. We already know that OB is the object distance, so it is written, we can write minus U, and OB dash, that is the, we have image distance, so we can write V here. Okay, so we get result number one. Now, dear student, there are another two triangles. Are there triangle DOF? Another triangle is A dash B dash F. Both are similar. D O F and triangle A dash B dash F. Both are similar. Okay. Now, if they are similar, then we can write the similarity triangle D O B is similar to triangle A dash B dash F. We, dear student, we know that D O equals to A B. So D O equals to A B. We can write. So instead of D O, we are writing A B. So A B upon A dash B dash equals to OF upon B dash F, OF upon B dash F. We already know from the result number one that AB upon A dash B dash equals to minus U upon V, okay, equals to OF. OF, we know the OF is the focal length. So we are writing F, B dash F. Now, dear student, take care that B dash F equals to OB dash minus OF. OB dash is V and OF is F. So, if we substitute that, we will write U minus U upon V equals to F V minus F. So, instead of B dash F, we can write OB dash minus OF. So, we can write V minus F. We do the cross multiplication minus U in bracket V minus F VF. So, we get minus UV plus UF minus minus equals to VF. Okay. Now we divide whole the term by UVF, UVF and UF. UV, UV is cancelled. UV, UF, UF is cancelled. VF, VF is cancelled. So we get minus 1 upon F plus 1 upon V equals to 1 upon U. So 1 upon V minus 1 upon U equals to 1 upon F. This is the we have Lenz formula. Okay.